What you're experiencing is a preview of the final piece I'm about to start making, which is the subject of this video. You are currently viewing roughly sketched iterations of how an idea I had gradually evolved into something I couldn't prevent myself from making. As I can never predict when and where inspiration will occur, when I am struck with an idea, if I don't immediately make a record of it, I will lose this vision as my mind's eye loses focus. As a consequence, I end up sketching on any reasonably flat surface I can find at short notice unless I have access to appropriate sketching tools and materials. However, due to the temporary nature of this method of documenting an idea, I take a photo of the sketch before it is lost, misplaced, or sanded off. Why don't I just carry around a small sketch pad or use an app? As there is really no satisfactory answer to this question, let's move on. I bought an LED globe smart light and started to design a table lamp to complement an earlier project of mine called Oculus. There's a link in the description. After figuring out how to mount the light into this one-to-one scale drawing I've done on 3mm MDF, I then cut it out and refine the overall shape and design, which is then used as the master template to make several copies from 12mm MDF to produce a series of templates and router guides, which will all come into effect at certain stages as the project progresses. After drilling a center pivot point for my router circle cutting guide, I then drill several holes to serve as location points for 10mm dowel to ensure perfect mirrored duplicate copies. This is a video in a series of build videos exploring design. Although I have made many objects in the past, I've never made a lamp like the one I intend to make here. These 10mm holes will serve as anchor points and will each receive a small section of 10mm dowel to ensure consistent location of all corresponding templates and components for this project. They'll come into effect a little later. It's been decided that this build video is not so much of a how-to video, it's more of a why video. Why complicate things? Why take a chance? Why bother? Why do it at all? To which I say, why not? Why not take a deep dive and explore the depths and perplexity of creativity? Not to mention the satisfaction gained from making something with your own hands. As this project is experimental, I didn't want to commit an untested idea to an expensive exotic species of timber until I had proof of concept. So I am using pre-glued Tasmanian oak panels bought on sale from my local hardware store. I do enjoy the process of sanding and seeing the piece take its final shape. However, I do not enjoy witnessing other people sand, so I have come up with a method to address this issue. I simply employ the motivational power of music and storm my way through the process. Here I'm making a template that's the same diameter as the globe. I'm doing this to ensure a nice fit, because what you will see in the following sequence is my version of what will be the lampshade for this project. To ease up the reassembly process, it's all about location, 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 which is what I'm doing here. I'm just making a series of location points. These positioning points will also prove their worth when it's time to change the globe and everything just locates back into its original position. Just in case you missed that, it's all about location. Now it's time to embellish this project and carve in some detail. Carving wood is something relatively new to me, and I have grand plans for this carving, but I have no idea if I can actually achieve what I hope it will look like. I find that if I just dive in and give things a go, it seems to work out. The legs for the lampstand are made from mirrored components. Screws are driven into what will end up being the internal connection of the legs. So the holes that remain will be concealed after their rough shape has been formed and the two halves are bonded and made whole. I prefer screws to attach the leg template to the timber blank, as I have more confidence in mechanical fixings rather than relying on double-sided tape. And now may I present a moment of drama, when I managed to capture the very second a bearing in my table router seized and threatened to pause in production, leaving me only one obvious course of action, so I deployed the backup services of my mini table router. I can assure viewers that this scene was not recreated or fictionalized for dramatic effect.
Thank you.
Here I'm applying a protective transparent skin, liquid skin that comes in the form of a satin hard wax oil, and after several liberally applied coats, it hardens over time and forms a modest armor protecting its occupant. At some point while on the journey of making this lamp, it became obvious that to do justice to the finishing shots of this project, it was necessary to design and construct a rotating display platform to facilitate a satisfactory conclusion. I built it off camera, and here I am reassembling it after applying several coats of paint. Now it's time to reflect. I carved an embryo out from where it was incubating in its timber membrane using tools and instruments, gradually manipulating and finally releasing it from its gestational cell.
Oh!
Now the embryo glows, emitting light and casting thought-provoking images, feeding into a creative loop, generating the next inspirational spark, inexorably setting me back on the path of creating more objects and loving the process of the journey. Thanks for joining me on this journey.